I would like to thank El Club de Madrid for this kind invitation to take part in this plenary session devoted to the state of democracy in 2021. We are here to face the global erosion of democracy and to respond to its contemporary challenges. This debate is very timely. Since the end of the Cold War, throughout three decades, the world has experienced a regular improvement of the number of democracies. In 2019, more than half of the countries in the world were democratic, and 57% of the world's population live in some form of democracy, compared to 36% in 1975. It was a time for democratic optimism. In recent times, democracy has continued to expand its global reach while experiencing a significant decline in quality. New democracies were often weak and fragile, and older ones struggled to guarantee sustainable economic and social developments in a very difficult international environment. More people today live in democratic society. There is globally more gender equality in politics. Elections are now the norm rather than the exceptions. And institutions are more representative and accountable than ever before. However, it is also clear that democracy seems to be at stake, and we need to identify key elements to restore the confidence of our citizens. Among the domestic causes of this deterioration, we might identify the crisis of representation of political parties and the rise of extremism and populism, shrinking political space for civil society, corruption, and general dissatisfaction among citizens. Global threats such as climate change, economic recovery challenges, or global insecurity also affect the quality of our democracies. In this context, the COVID-19 pandemic has put a halt to some of the processes of democratic reform while accelerating processes of democratic backsliding. We have witnessed examples of concentration of power in the executive or the lack of adequate scrutiny when enforcing states of emergency. Freedom of expression and movement, freedom of the press, and personal integrity and security were among the most affected human rights. Spain has the experience of an exemplary democratic transition after 40 years of dictatorship and authoritarianism. We are firmly convinced that democracy is the best political system to realize the aspiration for freedom, equality, dignity, and peace of our citizenship. We see the common values of inclusion, tolerance, freedom, justice, solidarity, and non-discrimination with our partners of the European Union. These core values are anchored under the pillars of our devotion to democratic elections, the rule of law, and the respect and promotion of human rights. From an international perspective, we are convinced that the reinforced multilateralism is key to overcome nationalist sentiments and the lack of global leadership. The challenges to democracies are multidimensional and far-reaching. They're not limited to a single region or any specific type of democracy. Promoting independent democratic institutions and strengthening the rule of law, combating corruption, and reinforcing democratic practices and the respect of human rights will be of paramount importance in this exercise. In that sense, we very much welcome the upcoming Summit for Democracy to be held next December, as well as the different initiatives, including those of El Club de Madrid. We are ready to contribute to them in collaboration with governments, international organizations, civil society, think tanks, and the private sector. Thank you very much.